Excuse me, hello, it's time to update me.
Yeah, actually, you look a bit plain.
Just plain?
Okay, and outdated.
Mate, you haven't updated me for the last 34 years.
Actually, you're so boring.
Okay, there's no need to be rude.
I think it actually might be time for a bit of a makeover. Hi, I'm Claydan, the go-to-market program lead for sales and success here at Canva. In today's tutorial, I'll be sharing some tips to help you create a memorable email signature. I'll highlight some of the do's and don'ts when it comes to deciding what to include. And I'll even show you how to add an animation to really spice things up. We upload tutorials like this one every week, so consider hitting that subscribe button if you want to see me again. All right, let's get into it. Think of your email signature like a virtual business card. If you're contacting someone new, it'll contribute to their first and sometimes lasting impression of you and your brand. So you'll want to make sure it stands out from the crowd whilst also reflecting your personality and quality of work. Let's take a look at some of the templates and the information you might want to include. You'll want to start by typing in email signatures into the search field on the Canva homepage. Any one of these can be customized to save you from having to start from scratch. I always find it much easier to start inspired. Just keep in mind that the ones with crowns are only for pro and team subscribers. Let's focus on the contents of this template. First off, I really like its simplicity. It includes all the standard info like name, job title, and contact details. It's very much to the point. It's the type of style that could suit a lot of different industries. Let me show you how easily I could customize it for, let's say a freelance photographer. I can change the text by clicking here. And then upload a photo or a logo in this tab. Just drop it in like this. Let's say this person doesn't conduct business over the phone. So instead, I'll get rid of the phone number and I'll add his Instagram handle. This will encourage recipients to check out his portfolio of work. I'm only going to add one social media platform so I don't overwhelm the recipient with too many options. According to the paradox of choice theory, the more choice is presented, the less likely it is for a person to choose anything at all. In this case, less is more, and the same goes when it comes to adding contact details. Lastly, I want to add an offer to entice the recipient to take action. Adding a call to action to your signature can be a subtle yet powerful marketing tool. Just make sure you keep it simple and up to date. This design's ready to be uploaded to any mail provider. If you're not sure how, stick around and I'll show you. I'll even explain how to add multiple images and hyperlinks in Gmail. Really technical stuff. For example, take this signature for a health coach. A lot of information and elements are similar to before, except for the social media icons. Once they're saved to my computer, I can start uploading each image to Gmail. You can use any mail provider, but I'm going to use Gmail today because it's super popular. Go to Settings. Make sure you're on the General tab and then scroll down to Signature. Click on the plus sign next to Create New and give it a name. Then hit this icon to start uploading. Next, we'll add hyperlinks to the images by clicking on the hyperlink icon. Before you hit save, scroll down and make sure your signature defaults are set to the right name. Let's see what this looks like. Perfect. If you plan on adding links to your signature, tell me in the comments which platform you'd add first. I'm curious to know what's most popular among different industries. Last up, I'll show you how to add some basic animations to make an email signature even more memorable. Let's use this design created for an architect. First, I'll switch his headshot out for a new logo. Let's animate it by heading up here and selecting a movement. Okay, I love this. Let's download this as a GIF file. And then we'll just upload this again to our email service provider by clicking on the insert image icon like we did before. And while we're here, we could also add a legal disclaimer to the very bottom of our signature. If you're not sure what to include, I recommend doing some research to determine what's best for your business. For example, a confidentiality disclaimer serves to prevent a breach. This could come in handy in case a confidential piece of information is leaked by the recipient. Whereas a personal opinion disclaimer separates the opinion of an employee from the formal views of the company as a legal entity. These are just a few examples of disclaimers. It's always best to seek professional legal advice, not legal advice from Clay on YouTube. Now it's over to you to start creating. Just remember to keep it simple and only add the information and elements your recipients are likely to need and appreciate. And if you're in need of more inspo, don't forget there are thousands of templates you can choose on Canva. If this has been helpful, we'd love it if you could like this video, share it with your friends and family, and subscribe to our channel for more design inspiration and content. I'd love to hear how long it's been since you last updated your email signature. Let me know in the comments. Thanks for watching.